Hola, buenas tardes, jóvenes. Estamos aquí con el coordinador del YPG, que nos va a explicar un poco más de lo que se trata la caminata de hoy.
Así es, José. Nosotros estamos aquí reunidos y nosotros nos estamos preparando para ese día 11, porque va a ser un evento donde muchos jóvenes que de pronto en ese momento nos están viendo y se han sentido así, se han sentido solos. Muchas veces la situación, los problemas que están pasando han hecho que ellos se miren como que no tienen a nadie con quien contar. A veces tienen personas, pero son personas que no les están dando el apoyo. Son personas que a veces, o jóvenes que a veces no se sienten entendidos, comprendidos. Y justamente nosotros vamos a llevar para usted esa esperanza y vamos a mostrarle a través del trabajo del YPG que ustedes no están solos, que nosotros estamos aquí. Y usted va a descubrir una vida nueva, al igual que muchos jóvenes que ya hemos tomado testimonios y palabras aquí en el YPG que han descubierto que no están solos, ¿no?
Entonces, aquí lo ven ustedes, vamos a estar hablando un poquito más de lo que va a ser este evento. Invitamos a todos ustedes, que como dijo el coordinador, están pasando por este problema, quizás tienen amigos, familiares, pero todavía se sienten solos. Los invitamos a todos a que nos acompañen. Hasta luego. Born and raised under the rain and a western wind, felt the way. Try to live up to the say I am. Is it any wonder? Shame comes calling my first name. Is there any question if I'm the one he left to blame? It's the same fight all over again. It's the same night breaking on my skin. It's the same night when you let me in. You let me in. You let me in. You are the end.
Hello guys, and we're here on the metro station, as you can see, and we're getting ready for the walk that we're going to be having today over there at the Santa Monica Pier. It's going to be for the event You Are Not Alone. And so here we have Jessica. Jessica, what block are you from?
Red block.
And Jessica is going to be telling us a little bit about her story and how her life changed once she joined us for the youth group. So Jessica, what changes did you see once you participated with us here?
Once I participated with YPG, the changes that I saw in me was that the depressions that I had were gone. I felt so much depression. I felt anxiety. I wouldn't be able to sleep at night. I had so many problems at home with my family. And when I joined the YPG helped me to overcome those obstacles. I found true friends. I found a new family. I'm happy, and I'm very excited to be in the YPG. I'm very happy to be in the YPG. It has helped me a lot.
And what would you tell Jessica for a youth that maybe has never been with us here at the YPG? Would you recommend it to them?
Yes, I would recommend YPG to those that haven't heard about us. Come and join the YPG. The YPG is going to help you to overcome your obstacles, to overcome family problems, depression, anxiety, everything that you're going through. The YPG will help you. You will find a family, friends, true people that will help you to overcome your obstacles.
Awesome. Thank you very much, Jessica. And guys, just like Jessica's story, we're going to be talking to a lot of other people that came here to join us today. So make sure you guys stick around. We'll be right back. Hey guys, what's up? As you guys can see, the weather's starting to feel a little nicer. I feel that peachy breeze. We're actually getting closer to Santa Monica, so make sure you guys stick around because you guys are going to be joining us here in a special walk we're doing for the You're Not Alone event, okay? So make sure you guys stay tuned because you guys are going to be enjoying this along with me as well, okay? We'll be right back.
It is reported that the average person spends 50 minutes per day on social media. Almost the same amount of time spent eating and drinking, while only 19 minutes per day are spent reading. As Christians, we are all too aware that what we see, hear, and think about feeds our soul. So, what have you been seeing on Facebook lately? What have you been feeding on? Let's invest in our spiritual lives and feed our relationship with God by giving more of our time to reading spiritual books. Less space and more books.
Hello guys, and as you can see, we're actually here at the Santa Monica Pier. You guys already know that we're gonna start this new walk for the You're Not Alone event. So make sure you guys stick around because it's gonna be really fun. It's gonna be really exciting. Make sure you guys don't miss out. Okay, we'll be right back. Guys, as you can see, we're actually making our way now towards the pier, and we're still passing out this information in regards to the You're Not Alone event. So make sure you guys stick around, and you know, as you guys can see here, you know, we're giving it our best. We're inviting others to make sure that, and this June 11th, you know, people come and change lives. People can see a change, you know, if they were feeling alone, if they were feeling depressed, whatever the problem it is that they were going through, so they can see that transformation in their life. All right, guys. So we're still going strong. I don't know if you guys can see, but I'm a little sweaty. I'm a little tired, but you know, we're still going strong, guys. So we'll be right back with another update. Make sure you guys stay connected, okay?
Hey guys, so I'm here with Jasmine from Red Block, and she's going to tell us what she thinks about this event and how the youth group helped her out.
Okay, so when I first came, I was insecure, I was depressed, and I didn't have any goals. But when I came to the youth group, I felt alone. I didn't know what I was gonna do with myself. But coming, I learned to have goals for myself. I learned to overcome my insecurities. I overcame my depression. And now I could say I'm me. Like, I could be myself in anything that I do. And this event is gonna help you because maybe you're going through, you know, something that you don't like to talk about. You have suicidal thoughts. Maybe you're depressed. You're stuck in your room and you don't know what to do with yourself. This event is for you.
So stay tuned to more information. Also, this event is nationwide. So you youth that is struggling with something, going through something, you can actually stay connected by going to ypgusa.com and see more information about where this event will be in your state. So stay connected.
The Youth Power Group, otherwise known as YPG, has been active across the USA as well as the entire globe. Our mission is to rescue youth who have been overwhelmed with daily pressure they face from society or personal traumas, who may have given in to drug use, self-destructive tendencies, or self-mutilation to escape the reality. We don't judge nor criticize anyone's lifestyle. We simply give advice and offer help to youth in need. We offer a variety of clubs that will bring out the best in each youth. Where others see failure, we see potential in life. Our culture club encourages youth to develop their theatrical, dancing, singing, and musical skills. We believe and encourage different forms of expression. We are constantly active and offer workshops for both beginners and for the more advanced. The sports club creates tournaments that give an opportunity to all players to compete regardless of experience level. Basketball, soccer, football, and volleyball are some of the sports you'll find here. The University Students Club is dedicated to all students who are interested in pursuing an advanced level of education. Outing includes trips to museums, internship locations, and college or career fairs. Interested in communications, our media project consists of various branches including photography, audio-visual production, online networking, and radio programming. Uniforce is dedicated to the neighborhood, providing community service and assists in the organization of YPG events. Find out more by visiting our website, ypgusa.com. Be sure to join us this weekend in your local YPG branch.
Hey guys, so I'm here with Oswaldo, the Yellow Block coordinator, and he's going to tell us how the YPG helped them and what he thinks about this event called You Are Not Alone.
Hey Maria, so I came to the YPG number one, insecure. I had a lot of insecurities with me. I felt alone. Honestly, I felt that there was no one for me, that nobody was able to understand what I was going through. But starting participating, I saw that helping hand, that there were people that actually cared. They helped me, you know, even at moments that things seemed wrong and that they were never going to change, you know, I started seeing that change as well. So it definitely was something that changed my whole life. I'm someone that has goals, someone that ambitions, you know, for great things in the future. And as well as, you know, being that helping hand for those that are going through that. And that's the reason why we're here, inviting people over for this big event, you know, June 11th. And it's going to be awesome. It's going to be a blessing. I'm really excited for it, and I can't wait for it.
All right, guys. So stay tuned for more interviews, and we will be right back. Walking in the walk. So, and I am here with Leslie. So,
hello.
So tell us, Leslie, how did the youth group help you? And what do you think about this event? How is this event going to help the youth that is watching us?
Well, honestly, the youth group has helped me in many ways because I used to be depressed. I used to have suicidal thoughts. I used to be in a relationship for 4 years that was horrible, but I still kept going on because I thought I loved the guy. So when I came to the YPG, I actually opened my eyes into, you know, the help with some of the youths right here that went through those similar situations. They knew what to say to me. They were there with me the whole time, the whole process that I was in, you know, like, and I believe that the youths that are going to be coming, the new ones, you know, like, you guys are going to get helped. You guys are not going to be alone through all this situation, the depression, because I know most people feel that way, that they can't have a new life because they don't know how to, you know? Mm-hmm. So I think that in this event that is coming up, most youths are going to be very surprised with the dramatic change that they're going to have. It's going to be a slow process, of course, but it's going to be a dramatic change.
Was it very difficult for you to change when you were coming to the YPG? Was it hard to leave your bad habits?
Actually, it was. It was. It took a lot of sacrifice. It took a lot of courage to leave the past that I was in. Something that it was like my rock, you know, something that I was like so used to coming into a new, different life, new situations.
New environment.
Exactly. Everything. Positive vibes. You know, it's always positive. It's not negative with my old friends. It was always negative. Oh, my goodness. So, yeah, it's totally different.
All right, so guys, you heard it from Leslie. This event is going to be different. This event is for you who feel alone. We are here for you.
Hey, man, how's everything?
I'm great, man. You know, everything at school is amazing. I'm getting good grades. I'm pushing myself to do better. Everything's going amazing.
What? You again? You're supposed to be dead.
Don't tell him that. Leave him alone. He's your brother.
Mom, you promised he'd be gone.
He can't change. Give him a chance.
Not again. He's crazy.
How's your family? My family, it couldn't be any better.
Just
no!
Mom,
no!
Are you kidding me?
Why are you doing this to us?
They love me and I love them.
She's right. You're never going to change.
At home, there's only peace.
Mom, I'm scared. Don't let him back in.
Guys, we are here in Santa Monica, and as you can see, there are a lot of people, but today something is different. Why?
Absolutely, and that different thing is that we're actually, the YPG is here in Santa Monica, and we are here to tell you a message, and that message is...
So don't miss out. June 11th, we're gonna have a very special event for those of you that say, you know what, I feel alone. I've been going through a lot of problems, difficulties, I've been bullied at school, I'm addicted to something, and there's no one for me, but there is. We are here to help you. So don't miss out at 3 p.m., 625 South Bonnie Ray in Los Angeles, California.
So see you there, and remember,
you're not alone!